Okay, so I want to show you some shortcuts that you can take when building your second project and every project in the future. We'll just go to Project Wizard and work through this. There's a 40, 45, 20, and so on. These guys are all found, the executable, ASM, and then the link, and then the lib are all found. So we say next. They usually would be. Now here's where we create a new file. And it'll go to PIC's my folder. You got to navigate down to where your folder is. Mine happens to be called Bill's PIC's Projects. Here's two projects I've already built. What I want to do is create a new folder so you don't have a mess of all your programs stuck in one place. So create a new folder, and I'll call this example 2-1, which is going to be one of the earlier examples you're going to be typing in. And when I say open on that, now I'm at this folder level, and now I just type in my program for my project, which is going to be called ex2-1. I can use the same name, no big deal. And when I say next, it's going to ask me to add the files. And then what I'm going to do is add the template, which has been stripped down here in the I/O ports. If I expand this, I'll see that. First of all, the linker we got to grab, right? So you can just grab that one. And the other thing is right here, no, down here is the stripped down version of that I/O program. Just find an old program and go up here and say add that. And you want to copy these to this new directory. And you want to rename this to whatever your new name's going to be. So you type slowly till it's highlighted, and then I'm going to say example 2-1. Don't forget to say dot ASM or else it puts it in the wrong spot. I've done that so many times. And then I'm finished. And if I view project, I'll be able to see there it is, and there's my linker file. I'm ready to go. So I'll double click on this and I can make the necessary changes to my program. I'll bring this up so we can see it. Make room here. And down in my main program, I'm going to just clear out my old program. I'll highlight it, hit the delete key, it's gone. And just start typing in the example. First statement I want, I'm going to do caps lock, MOV LW tab 99H, and put a comment. Which is load W with 99H. And I'm not going to type this whole thing because you're a lot better typing than I am. Move WF tab 12H, which is going to move the. I should have put this over a little further, which is to move the working register. Move W2 file location 12. That's the location in RAM. And that's good enough. And we'll just single step through this. And of course, I'm going to have all the other statements in that example, but I just wanted to illustrate this to you. So I'm ready to do a build all and see if I get any errors. Everything was successful. And if I looked at my output window, I probably would see all of the okay, there's the output window. It was hidden. So yeah, and build succeeded. I can just minimize this. And now what we need to do is go to debugger, select tool, and what we'll do is we'll go down to the sim. Now remember, there's three different things you want to be able to do. One is to simulate, which you can do at home with no hardware. When I click this, it'll just go through the program. We can single step and make sure things are working properly by watching the watch window. The second thing in the debugger is to do the ICD2. This you have to have that hardware. And with this, it actually connects to your target system, which is the processor. It goes through the hockey puck, and it'll actually show you the activity real time that's taking place on your processor. And the third thing you may want to do is is go to none. Make sure you click none on this. If you go to programmer, this would be the third thing you could do, which would be to actually program it via the ICD-2. And so when the programmer ICD-2 is selected, you will actually be downloading your program to it, and then you can pull the cables on it, and the hardware runs all on its own. So let's go back to none. Make sure you get rid of that, none. And then go back to debugger, select tool, and we're going to do a simulation. Let's get rid of the output window. I'll shrink that down. Now, we want to create some watch windows, so let's pull this up, put a watch window in here. So we want to do view, watch. And what sorts of things do you want to watch? Well, we're working with the W register, the working register. And that's one of the special function registers way down at the bottom because it begins with a W. Click on that, add it, and there it is. It's got zeros in it right now, and I'll show you how to reset that later. And the other thing we want to watch is file number 12. And now that is not one of the SFRs. We have to actually double-click in this area and type in 12 hex, enter, and file number 12 will appear. Now as we single-step, step into, we watch... of course, this is going to hide my watch window, so I'll have to drag this up a little bit higher. I can drag this down a little bit so we can watch this. The W register will be loaded with a 99, so when I hit step into, there it goes, 99. When I hit the next one, it'll load location 12. Location 12 got loaded. Now, if I want to run this again, I could hit reset, and it goes back to the main, but nothing got reset in the RAM. So you have to go up to debugger clear memory, and you want to clear out your GPRs. When I do that, I got rid of the information in 12. There is no command on clearing out the special function registers. If I clear all memory, what that does is it clears out my program too, but my ASM file is still on the screen. I can hit that. It doesn't hurt anything, but I have to build again if I'm going to do that because my ASM got wiped out, or my code memory got wiped out. So I build again, and it built and was successful. Now I can run a simulation, but the working register still has information. You double-click on it, you can type in 0, enter, and wipe it out that way. And again, now I can single-step, and I'll get the 99 in the working register, and then I'll get the 99 in location 12.